a guy that I played Babe Ruth, Connie Mack with, competed against in minor league baseball. Remember, we were sitting out one day in Navajo playing. I was playing for Montalon. He was playing in Navajo. And I told Rickey, "Hey, you're not all of that." We saw each other again through the minor league season, and we met again in Albuquerque. And I told Rickey, "If you ever take me deep, I'll leave the country." He took me deep. They called him to the big leagues. I never saw him again until he was with the Yankees. But it's hard to talk about Rickey in a condensed version because there's so much to be said. He's a great friend, a good fisherman. He talked about the greatest players of time, all time, when he was at the Hall of Fame induction last week. Well, Rickey, for me, is one of the greatest players of all time. When you speak about Major League players and Hall of Fame players and the best in the game, for some reason, people get caught up in the muscle of the game, the RBIs, the home runs. The reason why Rickey is one of the top four or five players for me in Major League Baseball history is because he had impact in any game he ever played. As a pitcher, we had our battles. Probably most of them he'll say he won. As I get older, I forget. I think I won most of them. Being from Oakland, you go through a lot of things, and a lot of things that we've learned have made Rickey the player that he's become, the Hall of Famer that he is, and a player that Major League history will never forget. Records that will never be broken, accomplishments that will never be touched. In closing, I'd like to say, there'll never be another Rickey Henderson, not in this sport. There'll never be another Rickey Henderson in this city of Oakland. I give my appreciation to the Oakland A's, to Major League Baseball, and somehow it doesn't even seem like this honor is enough. To my greatest friend, to the greatest honor that you could ever achieve, congratulations, Rickey, today.